Welcome to the Vinyl Siding Institute's training video on installing vinyl siding. This video provides demonstrations of techniques that should be used in the field when installing vinyl siding, trim, soffit, and fascia. In this section, we will cover receiving channels, transitional channels, soffit, and fascia. Soffit covers the area at the eave of the roof or porch ceilings. Soffit comes in solid, vented, and combination panels in vinyl or aluminum. Vented panels allow critical airflow into the attic area. Consult local building code for the proper amount of ventilation required. Local environmental conditions and building codes, especially in high wind zones, may call for different installation techniques. Always consult the manufacturer's instructions and local building codes for the correct soffit installation techniques. The procedure used to install soffit depends on the construction of the eaves and gable. Open eaves have exposed rafters or trusses and are typical in new construction. Enclosed eaves have soffit already in place and are typical of re-siding projects. The first step in installing soffit is to install a soffit receiving channel onto the wall. This channel must be applied level to the bottom of the fascia board. For open eaves, an F channel can be installed directly into the wall, or a wood block strip can be used for installing J channel. You can also cut tabs into the nailing hem of a J channel and attach this modified channel by nailing into the tabs. For enclosed eaves, J channel can be attached directly to the existing wood soffit. Using any of these options, you should nail the channel a maximum of every 8 to 12 inches, positioning the nails in the center of the slots. Do not nail tight. Leave about a 1/32nd of an inch gap. In most cases, you are not required to install a receiver into the fascia board. You must cut vinyl soffit panels to fit the span. If the span is more than 16 inches, you must use intermediate nailing strips to reduce the span and prevent sagging. Always follow the manufacturer's recommendations. Measure from the wall to the fascia board. Subtract a half inch to allow for panel movement. Mark this measurement on the panel. Use tin snips or a circular saw with a fine-toothed plywood blade installed in reverse direction or a vinyl siding blade to cut soffit panels. Insert the panel into the receiving channel while checking that the panel is square. Then nail the other end into the fascia board. When turning a corner, you usually install a transitional channel to receive mitered panels. In some cases, where adjacent soffits are different dimensions, you must make a square corner. You can use back-to-back J-channel, a factory-formed H-divider, or a field-formed aluminum T-channel. With all these options, make sure that the channel system is securely attached. Now, miter the soffit panels and install. You can also field-bend the soffit panel at the peak of the gable. At the peak of the gable, use back-to-back J-channel to make the transition. Fascia covers can be factory-formed vinyl or aluminum. However, they are usually field-formed from aluminum trim sheet on the portable field break. To field-form a fascia cover, measure the board to be covered. Keep in mind that the formed fascia has to cover the edges of the soffit panels. Form the desired shape. Make sure to include a hem to eliminate waviness of the trim coil. Now, install the formed piece onto the wood fascia. In most cases, the top of the fascia cover slides behind a roof drip edge. If a drip edge is not present, utility trim can be installed to receive the fascia cover. In these situations, you can snap lock lugs onto the fascia panels. To install aluminum fascia, pre-drill nail holes a maximum of every 24 inches, aligned with the V-shaped groove in the soffit. Never nail trim sheet tight to the wood surface. If more than one length of fascia is required, overlap two pieces to ensure a smooth appearance. On overlapping fascia, make sure to overlap them a minimum of 3/4 of an inch. When installing vinyl fascia covers, always follow the manufacturer's installation instructions. An F channel must be installed onto the bottom of the fascia board. Cut 1.5 inches of the lip and overlap by 3/4 of an inch. At inside and outside corners, overlap tabs a minimum of 1 inch and miter the bottom of the fascia so that the finished area is attractive. Where a horizontal eave transitions to a gable or rake, forming must be installed to support a bird box. Create a bird box out of trim sheet or a vinyl fascia cover. Install the bird box as a fascia cover for the eave. The eave and rake fascia covers are installed after the bird box. To get more installation best practices and learn more about our certified products, visit vinylsiding.org.